no filter. Gorgeous, make them drop dead, you a killer. Shower you with all my attention. Yeah, these are my only intentions. Stay in the kitchen cooking up, got your own bread. Heart full of equity, you're an asset. Make sure that you don't need no mentions. Yeah, these are my only intentions. Shout out to your mom and dad. Shout out to your mom and dad for making you. Staying in a vision, they did a great job raising you. When I create, you're my muse. The kind of smile that makes the news. Can't nobody throw shade on your name in these streets. Triple threat, you a boss, you a bank, you a beast. You make it easy to choose. You got a mean touch, you can't refuse. No, I can't refuse it. Picture perfect, you don't need.
Hi there, so I'm here to teach you some rifle work. And basically the way this is set up is there's 4/16 of beginner and then 4/16 of like an intermediate advanced. And then obviously throughout it, there will be different options that'll kind of give you and kind of tell you like, oh, instead of this double, you could do a single here. Or you, instead of the six, you could do a five, like different things like that. And as you're working on it, you can kind of go into the more advanced part of it if you're wanting. And then to learn it, all you do is just face the camera to learn. You don't have to turn around or try to reverse it or like put your camera up against a mirror or anything. You just put your phone, watch it, and then literally just make sure your rifle's going the exact same way that mine is going. So to start, we're gonna go ahead and have that right hand on the neck. Left hand's just gonna be right over that hand. And then we're gonna face the back in first position. And it's gonna be right in the center of our body. So we're gonna be standing just like this, but facing the back. We're gonna go ahead and hit out with that left foot into four starts. And we're gonna go one. So that first count is very sharp, it hits on one. Now from here, you're gonna go ahead and let the rifle keep going over, and you're gonna turn over, down, and you're gonna bring the rifle up. So again, that move, I go from here, rifle goes over my head, I take off with that right foot, down, and up. So five, six, and five, six, seven, and one, two, three, four, five, and six. So now you're in this position, make sure you get a super big lunge, make sure those feet are turned out to the corners, and now you're up here. This left hand is kind of at that shoulder level, right hand still on that neck, honestly depending on the size of your gun to where your left hand is gonna end up. From here, we're just gonna go into a passe on 7, 8, and you're gonna land back into four starts. So you're not gonna go passe, lunge, you're gonna go passe, four starts. So that whole opening goes 8 down, 5, and 6, and 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. From here on count 9, you're just gonna hit 9. And then you're gonna kinda hold count 10. Now from here, you're gonna pull that right hand back towards your face. Left hand's gonna push down, and you're just gonna release a little double, up, and grab. And now notice that it's my wrist and my arms making it happen. I'm not fully lifting all the way from my shoulder. I'm just kinda pulling back. So if you wanna just get used to that action, make sure that right hand is on the buckle, or that little swivel on your rifle, like where it's taped, and then left hand is gonna be on the tip. So I'm gonna be here with those hands, and I literally just pull. And when I pull, I let go. And you can try the little one first, here. And then as you get more comfortable with it, you just pull a little bit harder and go up, up, grab. And then you're gonna be catching that in second position at that 45 degree angle. So again, I just hit on, I'm here. I just hit on 7, 8. I'm gonna go 9, 10, and I'm gonna pull on 11, 11, 12, 13, and 4. And then you kind of have a dead count on 14. It's depending on which one you do, if you do a single or a double, whatever you're interested in. So from this double now, we're gonna go ahead and hit, and we're gonna go hop onto that left side and then hop onto that right side. So we hit, we go up and grab, third, four, and now on 15, 16, we go fifth, six. And then we're gonna do one more on count one, one. And now when we do that count one from this moment, we're just gonna pop the rifle to the neck. So we're gonna go hit, hit, pop. And now the rifle's over here. And now when we do that too, we're just gonna have the left arm go out. So it's kind of pushing to a lunge in there. So let's just do those first 16 counts. We go 5 and 6, and 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 5, 6, 1. Now from here, you keep that motion going from that count one. Now you go flat, and now you're just gonna turn all the way around and down. So notice that I stayed in that toaster. I go straight down, so the strap is facing up, bolt is down, and I go all the way around, keeping that rifle the same way, no twist, right back down. When I get to this moment, I go ahead and push it forward and over that body. So again, I'm here, you can see it from the side. I do push the rifle forward and go over. I don't slide up at the body. So I just did 5, 6, 7, 8. Left foot is gonna pull a coupe. Right foot's just standing straight, and this is flat on your shoulders. Both hands are over. So kind of see my hand positions. Both hands are just over in that coupe. So now, from that coupe, I'm gonna go ahead and just drop into second, just like this. And now as I drop, I'm gonna let go with the left hand and push it out to my right hand. Let it go all the way around. Then I'm gonna go ahead and keep this flat. As you can see from the side, I'm gonna keep it flat. And it's gonna go in. I'm gonna grab my left hand over and my thumb is facing me. So your thumb is doing this, and that's how you're grabbing your rifle, just like that. And now from there, you just keep the motion going, unwind, then you dip for your triple, and then you release a triple on 15. If you're comfortable going on the floor already, you wanna challenge yourself, go to the floor. If you're not, you can totally just catch up here, and then you can go to the floor after. Or if you're comfortable with the triples or your doubles or your singles, whatever you're wanting to toss, then go straight to the floor. Up, floor. And then you'll be catching like this with that head to the right. So again, let's just do that last 16. I'm here, I go 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4. Then I go straight over 5, 6, 7, 8. Let me screw my camera. Then I drop down right on 9, 10, 11, 12. I grab thumbs towards me. Then I go 13, dip 14. And I release on 5, 6, 1. And then catch on that knee if you're comfortable or not. So now from here, we're gonna shoot straight out. When we shoot straight out though, instead of just keeping that hand under, we're gonna go ahead and make a circle with those first two fingers, and you're gonna put the strap inside that circle. So you can kind of see, I go from here with my hand fully on it. I just kind of do this with the strap, and I do this as I'm sliding. So I go strap, and I slide all the way down, and now my thumb is underneath that strap. So I'm here, and I go slide, and then from this slide, I pull up, and I leave just my thumb in there, so my hand is out and my thumb is pushed through the strap. So this is catch on 1, 3, 5, and that hand is open. Now from this moment, it looks a lot more confusing than it is. From this moment, that thumb is through and you just leave that hand open. All you do is you kind of pull this arm and just let it drop and you re-grab when it comes back up. So again, you're open, you go down, grab. And that's all it is. You don't have to pull down. You don't have to do anything with this hand. You just literally leave it open, open, and then re-grab it when it comes back up. Do make sure that you are pulling with this hand. Don't just let it kind of do this, because then it will slide off. So you have to make sure pull and around. So this hand has to pull to start that action. So I'm here, I caught on 1 and 3, 5, and I do this on the ground 2, 7, 8. And now from 8, I'm gonna step up into second. I'm gonna go over, I'm gonna keep the rifle going. I'm leading with the bolt, so I'm twisting my arm and I'm grabbing on top. So now I'm ending here. So that left arm is on top, right arm is over here on top in the swivel. So from that triple, or let's actually go from count 8, I go 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and 3, 5, 6, 1, and 3, and 5, and 7, 8, 9. So that grab is right on that count 9. Now from this count 9, I'm gonna go ahead and shoot this out, and notice that it's behind my arm right now. But when I shoot it out, I'm gonna go out and let it go under my arm, and I'm gonna pull it back in and then grab both under, just like this. So again, I just caught, did all this stuff. I grabbed over, and now from this moment, I do a big lunge. Lunge, let it unwind, grab under. Now from here, I just go straight over, bring it to flat, and then it's gonna keep going, flat over and onto the shoulder. So it's a bunch of crazy pathways right there. So you really wanna make sure you're going here, unwind, shoot over to flat. When it's going like this flat, that's kind of when you bring it over the head as it's traveling that way. So you don't go here, over, down, shoot. It just kind of blends all together into that moment. So again, I just did 1, 3, 5, 7, 8, 9, 10. I went 11, 12, and now I go 3rd, 4th, 5th, and 6th. And now instead of just putting the rifle on your shoulder, you're gonna put that left hand with that thumb facing just like this. And you can kind of put it a little bit before the swivel. So don't put it directly on it, just put it a little bit before. And it's that flat with that bolt facing forward. And then we're gonna be in a low forced arch. So once again, from count 8, those feet, 5, 6, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 4, 5, 6, 1, and 3, and 5, 7, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 4, 5, 6. Then you're done with that 16. So now from here, you're gonna go ahead and pull that left hand towards your face, and you're gonna push the right hand directly straight up. So left hand is gonna control all of the speed, and then right hand is gonna control all of the height. So remember that as you're tossing. So I'm gonna use those in conjunction with each other, and they're gonna go together, up and grab. And we're doing a little double. And if you're not comfortable doing a double, then you can just do a single. But obviously you're trying to work your way up that double. So try it a couple times. If you're just focused on getting the piece in one, try it with a single. And then after you get the piece comfortable, then move all those things up and advance them. So again, I get to here, I'm gonna go up and grab, or up and grab. And this releases on count one, and then we'll be catching on three. One and three, or one, two, and then hold on three, if you're doing the easier version. So I just went third, fourth, fifth, sixth, going up one and three. Cool, and then you kind of see the rotation. This would be the single, and then this is the double. So make sure you're either doing one of those. If you're doing like this, that's most likely too much. So make sure it's just a double as you're releasing. Cool. So I just went again for me. I went five and six and five, six, seven, eight, and nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 1, and 3, and 5, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 1, and 3. Cool. So I'm here and I'm in a 4-star. Try to get lower than I just got. You catch. Now from here, you're gonna turn back this way. Left Shanae turn over that shoulder. Shanae turn. Keep it at that level. And now from here, you're gonna go car and down. So that is catch on 3. And now I turn. 4, 5, 6. I'm in a big second, and I just go 7, 8. And I'm in that kind of seatbelt angle. From here, I'm just gonna go ahead and pop that right hand. I'm gonna go pop, grab. I'm gonna grab with that left hand, backhand. A couple fingers into the bolt, like 2 or 3 fingers into the bolt to grab. Make sure though, if you're doing push lift, it shouldn't be this, how fast that spins. It should be more float. Float, grab. So kind of see those differences again, quick or float, grab. So the float one, you wanna make sure that both hands are moving at the same time, both together. And then the fast one is when you push lift. So that's push lift. You don't want the push lift right now in this instant. You want together, grab. And then a kind of way to test that, if you see that your rifle's looking different than mine, you can open that hand completely. Make sure you're squeezing this hand. Open this hand just like this and just literally kind of pop and get used to that feeling of popping your hand. Don't hold it. Just open it up and get used to that feeling. And that'll kind of help you get used to what you're supposed to do. So now from that backhand, let's just finish it out. I'm here, I'm gonna grab in a left 4-starch. I'm gonna go straight up. Now from this moment, I'm gonna go directly to a dip and I'm gonna release another triple. I'm gonna catch straight up. This one, you can kind of do whatever you want under it and you can catch any way you want. You can be cute at the end. You can just do a standard triple if you want. You can catch here. Try to make your position interesting. Something you've seen online, something you've seen your instructors or your friends or anyone do. So let's go ahead and do the whole thing with counts now. And 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 11, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 11, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 9, 11, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 9, 11, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 9, 11, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 9, 11, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 9, 11, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 9, 11, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 9, 11, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 9, 11, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 9, 11, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 9, 11, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 9, 11, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 9, 11, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 9, 11, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, gonna be right under that left hand, just like this. Make sure no white is showing, it's just straight up like that. And I'm gonna be in first position, turned out with those feet, and then rifle just flat on that ground. And I'm gonna have my head down. So from here, I'm just gonna slide that right hand down one. So my right hand goes to belly button, left hand at face level. Now from here, I'm just gonna go flourish outward and up. And now as it's coming back in, I'm gonna twist, grab, so that that strap is facing that way. So again, I went flourish out and grab on the strap. And now as I do that flourish, I'm just gonna step out into a lunge, lunge, and grab. And I'm gonna step across in that grab. From here, I'm just gonna twist, do a little single, and grab. So go ahead and try that a couple times. Make sure that you're sending it to that right hip. You're not doing this and getting a level change, because we're gonna go into a double from there, down. And from here, we're gonna twist up and grab. So it goes down, up, grab. So from the beginning, I go 5, 6, five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four, grab five, six, up, seven, eight, grab nine. So now from that count nine, I keep that same motion going. I just caught, I go straight down. I'm gonna go over and I'm gonna bring the left hand to the tip and I'm gonna pull my left foot to coupe it. So that whole opening thing, I go up one, out, in, up, oh, did too much. I go here, release, grab. I'm gonna continue that, grab, continue. And now from here, I'm at count 12. I'm gonna go ahead and push this straight forward and I'm gonna twist the rifle inward. And now I'm grabbing on the strap again. So again, cause this hand's a little bit confusing, I'm here on that count 12. I push it straight out. I'm on the bottom of the strap. And now from here, I just keep twisting, goes under my arm and into here. And now you can see my arms are kind of opposite because I'm ready to do like a Z pull toss. So again, from the beginning, I go five and six and five, six, seven, eight. Up one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Grab nine, 10, 11, 12, third and four. This is count 14. From here, I'm just gonna push my left hand out, push my right hand this way, and you're gonna go pop and grab. It's a very small, very floaty toss, so you can just go fifth, six, one. So go ahead and try that a couple times on your own. Make sure in that second position, fifth, six, one. Now from this grab, instead of catching it normal, you're gonna go ahead and let that right hand come all the way around the back and catch behind. So make sure that's why you wanna let it float. You don't want it to be like this, because you won't have time to get around. You wanna make sure you float, grab. And now you're catching out flat, and I just twisted my body to force arch. So again, notice I didn't take any steps. I didn't do this to go catch or forward. I just went from that second, I just dug down and twisted to get that arm around on the other side. So that whole 16, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, and nine, 10, 11, 12. And now from here, oh sorry, coupe, 12. Now I'm gonna pull out, third and four, float, fifth, six, one. And now my left arm is on my right hip, and I'm crossed around. And notice that my tip is pointing straight across. From here now, I'm just gonna swipe that left arm straight out, and I'm gonna do a little jump turn. Jump and down. I'm gonna land right in that second position turned out. I'm gonna let the right hip keep going so the rifle drops with it, and I'm gonna go ahead and let it roll over that wrist, roll, grab, up. And now when I catch that, I'll be in a left forced arch. So again, I just caught behind my back. I did that jump turn. And now landing that jump turn, I let that right hip drop down and in. Sorry, to forced arch. So let me just show you what that looks like. Five, six, seven, eight. Grab one, two, three, four, and five, six, seven. And you're hitting right on a little click or clap that happens to that music. So make sure this is a sharp seven. Kind of dig down, get that shoulder forward. Don't make it so here. Make it a little more dig down, straight arm, down like that. Have a little more like style and presence to it rather than being like that. Cool. So I just hit that position on seven. I'm just gonna grab bolt. So I'm here, I twist this back towards me and I just grab on the bolt. I'm gonna let this go around and re-grab. So I'm here on seven. As I do that, I'm just gonna go to coupe, coupe, and grab. Then I'm gonna dip and I'm gonna release a six on, I think 13, 10, 11, 12, yes. So you're gonna release a six on count 13 and then you're gonna be catching on one. So you'll go nine. 10, a little windy, 9, 10, 9, 10, 11, 12, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1. And you'll be catching right on that count one, and then you'll catch as hard as you can, obviously. Make sure you stop it at flat, because the next thing we're going to is a movement opposite, so you can't let it drop down or else you'll be late to the next thing. Okay, so those whole first two 16s, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 3, and 4, float here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 11, 12, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1. And you'll be catching right on that count one. Don't drop your hip on your catch like I just did. Make sure you're slamming that right hand in as hard as you can so that your toss stops flat. Keep those hands down like you know how you do in your technique. Make sure those arms go straight up and try to take as minimal steps as possible into that catch. Cool. So now from here, I just caught on that count one. I'm gonna go ahead and go up and over above my head. I'm gonna let it go down behind me and just try grabbing, re-grab with that right hand. So again, I go over, down, up, grab. So now instead of grabbing on that same side, I'm gonna push that right hand around and grab behind my back. Over, down, up, grab. So you can kind of see how I'm grabbing. So I'm down and I'll do it three. Down, up, grab. So I grab that thumb down on that neck. Notice how I'm really letting my rifle float. I'm not trying to do this. Spin it crazy fast. I'm letting it float. Up, swing up, grab, float right into that thing. So now I just did that to the back, float up, grab, left arm is placed and tall. From here, I'm gonna let the tip swing. I'm gonna go up and catch. And now for those of you that did it right off the bat, awesome. For those of you that didn't, here's the way to break it down. You go here and you kind of swing that tip outward. Just practice going swing, grab, just with that right hand. Same hand grabbing, don't try to grab over yet. So you go swing, grab a couple times, then you try adding the left hand onto it too. Swing, grab, and get used to what it feels with both hands on it. Swing, grab, just get used to that motion, and grab. Now from there, you just let the right hand go. Swing, grab, and now it's just that left hand grabbing. And notice it's not right in front of my face, it's over here. Swing, grab. So there's no danger of it actually hitting me, it's just over here. It looks like it's gonna hit me from that angle, but it's not. So series of that, you go here, down up, grab, and grab. And it goes straight over that head. So now also make sure you're digging the forced arch on that movement. Over, down up, grab. And now from this moment, when you push back up to that hand, you're gonna reach outward and bring it down. As you reach outward, you're just gonna lean away, make sure that toe is pointed as it comes off the floor. Both legs are straight, and I'm gonna do that as I reach over. Over, and I'm gonna bring this to flat. Right hand is right on that buckle. Cool. So I just caught my six on five, six, seven, eight, and one, two, up, three, four, five, six. Then I release on seven, I swing, I release on eight. Seven, eight, open, nine, I'm gonna lean back. Nine, chasse, 11, 12, I'm gonna jump on 13. So I'm gonna go right chasse, 11, 12, down. Now from here, I'm gonna step across and switch my right hand to under. Now I'm only gonna do a little glissade. You don't have to try to do a second leap. If you want to, you can, but I'm just doing a little glissade, over, and that left foot is stepping behind. So again, I'm going right chasse, step, step, glissade, down. And now with the rifle, this is over. I go right chasse, step, step. Remember my hand switches on that cross. And now as I do the glissade, my rifle just goes over and tuck. And then my foot is stuck behind. And this is gonna be your count one. So I just jumped. I went over 9, 11, enter, 4, 5, 6, 1. I hit to the side. That part is gonna be a little bit slower, just so that if you're doing a higher jump, you can get all the way through it and still be able to catch up to everyone else. So you're here, chasse, chasse, step, step, glissade, over. From this moment now, you're gonna go ahead and release that butt down, and you're gonna hit, if you see me from the side, to that 45 degree angle, back with that rifle. So you're gonna have to go up, re-grab on that other side. So it looks here, just from this angle, it goes up and re-grab. And you're trying your best, this is why I have your feet in this position, because you're trying your best not to have to wobble around to go grab it. You're just here and you can lean away from it, lean away right into that catch. And again, try to keep those feet as planted as possible because it is gonna be a hard position to toss from. Cool. So I just did that 45 toss. I caught right behind me. And now from this moment, I'm gonna go straight out. And I'm gonna step with that left foot in the forced arch, but I'm gonna put my knee on the floor and I'm gonna step at the same time that my knee touches down. Now from here, I'm gonna let the rifle just go over and down to a dip. So again, I'll come closer so you can see my hands. I just stabbed, my hands just do this. Grab over and dip. So you do that same thing as you stab. Stab and dip. So I just released on one, up two, three, four, five. I'm gonna go over six and seven, I stab. Then this goes eight, nine, 10, I dip. Now from here, I'm gonna toss a quad on 11 and I'll be catching on 13, I believe. Six, seven, nine, 10, 11. Third, four, I'm gonna be catching on count 14. I'm gonna scoop it. Four, fifth, six, it goes above my head, but I'm gonna switch my left hand to under as I slam down on the floor on count one. So again, I toss on 11. I catch on 14, we discovered, and I go 14, fifth, six, one. So seven, eight, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, third, four, fifth, six, one. Also, don't put your hand on your knee when you push like I just did. Try to push your hand either here or behind you after you release. So here, so it just looks, oh my God, so it just looks a little bit cleaner into that grab and over. But again, don't hit the ground or put your hand on your knee or do any of the things I just did. Toss it beautifully like another one. Okay, so now the whole thing with counts, I go five, six, seven, eight, one, two, three, four, five, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, third, four, fifth, one, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, and 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9, 10, 11, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1. So yeah, thanks guys, that's basically it. I hope you had fun learning it. Again, I know it's super confusing learning from video, so if you have any questions, or you're like, oh, I really can't do this part, or how did you get this part, or you didn't explain it well in the video, just go ahead and message me. I'll put my little app for Instagram in the description, and then the song and everything. I'm sure y'all know the song, it's Intentions by Justin Bieber, but just in case you don't, that description will be down there. And yeah, thanks for giving me the opportunity to teach you guys. I hope it all made sense, thanks.